Hello, everyone. Welcome to Crossroads Podcast Ministry. We're excited. We are here with Preston Files and here with Brian Matthew, Steve Woodrow here. We're excited. We're here with Preston, and who started this and launched this new thing called Not So Boring Bible. It's an online thing. I don't know what to call it, except so
they're
maybe
called websites.
We just, before we get into what that's all about, though, Preston, tell us something about you and your family. Tell us a little bit about something about you.
Yeah, so I'm married. My wife, Catherine, and I have been coming here for about 5 years. We have three kids downstairs with Brian. Brian's doing an awesome job working on them. But yeah, we got Eli, who's seven, Greta, who's seven, and then Madeline's almost five. So really rounding out the future generation there. Nice. But love this church and love what you guys are doing, and just such a blessing to be plugged into such a great home church.
Yeah. Awesome. That's awesome. And it's great having you part of the family, obviously. It's been great getting to know you, too, and just hear your heartbeat and see how this this ministry has been birthed. So talk to us. Let us know, what is Not So Boring Bible? What is it, right?
Yeah.
And I think, where did this idea come from? What's the kind of the genesis of this in your life?
Yeah, so we've got 5 hours, right? So we'll start. But Not So Boring Bible.
It's a Not So Boring podcast.
Right. We'll keep it short, so it's not so boring.
Exactly.
I'll save you my whole testimony and life story. But basically 3 years ago, I mean, I've been a Christian a very long time. I've been going to churches a long time. And I had a Bible, never not without a Bible, but never consistently looking at this thing as something you should read daily, or just like, what is in there. I kind of know some stuff. There's other stuff. I'll do some of this stuff. I won't do some of this stuff. And just that picking and choosing. I mean, you've had sermon series that just like light you where there's a path. You got to go one way or the other. And so, yeah, about 3 years ago, I just, whatever the Holy Spirit was doing or whatever makes you come alive. But man, I was just on fire. I wanted to know what was in the Bible. If I'm going to believe this thing, this old ancient book just became very cool. For every little detail it says and all the big stuff that I learned in Sunday school when I was five, that I'm just kind of like bored, heard it. Flood story, got it. There were two people in the garden, got it. And you just kind of get those watered down children versions. I think that does a huge injustice just in Christians and in their faith and in growing. They kind of think, man, I've heard it. I know it. And so opening up a new story, like a huge series in Jonah, and there was this whale, I remember that back in the day, but like actually seeing the struggles and what Jonah is saying and how he's acting, and taking that to the next level and actually reading what's in the Bible. And man, that just got, I don't know, I can't explain why it got exciting, but it got not boring. Yeah. And so in that journey of, I mean, this has been stepping stones of faith where I can't say I saw, it wasn't like I got zapped or struck or a lightning bolt or a burning bush. But man, just stepping stones of faith where I'm like, okay, I'm going to do this. And somehow I end up here on a podcast talking about a nonprofit I started. And it's like, what just happened? So, all that to say, like, it's just been a long journey of in that, I like to learn just kind of like quick, random little tidbits. And then all of a sudden I'm sucked in, and the next thing I know I'm on Wikipedia for 30 minutes reading whatever it is. But there's just like that fishhook. There's something that makes, like, if we were signing up for hour-long sermons and like we'd get to go to a weekend retreat, not like, kind of give me the quick thing here. Yeah. So I like that. And I was looking, this is early 2019, a year and a half ago. I was looking on the App Store where stuff is on the internet, for Bible trivia apps, because I like Bible trivia. I want to see, test my knowledge, or what do I not know? And man, I was bored. I was literally, I got through like five apps, downloaded those, and I was done in a week, and there were repetitive things. And I was just like, this is not making me excited to read the Bible. So how do you build a better mousetrap, or how do you make people excited about the Bible? And so I basically built the thing I wanted. You know, why do I have all these tools, or why am I blessed with the gifts I'm blessed with and you're blessed with different gifts? I have like all the tools. I do web and graphic design. I build websites. So what I did was built this thing. And literally I called it Not So Boring Bible because, I just, the, worst thing people can do, I think, is when you look at Christians and just around the table, like, why are more people not reading the Bible? And so I've read it, I heard some passages, but like, are you daily reading it? No, like, I mean, there's a long list of reasons why people don't read the Bible more. I don't have time, it doesn't speak to me, I don't get stuff out of it, or I'm not entertained, or the laundry list is long.
Yeah.
And boring, it's boring, is on there. And so literally, if I can cross off one of the reasons people don't read the Bible, I don't know how to shake a bunch of Christians, yeah. But that's
so
the goal.
You're answering
it's not
now,
boring.
I think, at least some of that, but anything else you want to say about just your vision for this? What is your vision for getting people to this site and grappling
yeah.
with this Bible trivia?
Yeah, that's a great question. I'm 2 months into building my, my idea, and I don't know, right? Like, wherever the Lord leads, wonderful. Sure. I started with Bible trivia. I don't like that term. If somebody says, what do? Bible trivia is like, man, that sounds so boring. So I'm trying to find. But at the core, it's Bible trivia. And we can go through some fun questions because I think, obviously, if you read some of these.
It's kind of an oxymoron, isn't it? There's nothing trivial about the Bible.
Right, exactly.
So it's kind of a play on words.
When I was looking for, when I was coming up with names, I'm asking my family and stuff, but my dad, he threw out not so trivial trivia. That's in the trash pile of names that didn't make it, but it got to be not so boring Bible. Just fun trivia questions is literally the pulse of it. So I started as a Christian nonprofit, and literally the mission, if we're accomplishing the mission, the nonprofit is healthy and doing great. The mission is to help others see the Bible as anything but boring, mm-hmm. By reading it.
Right.
So on these questions, there's no commentary, there's no side notes. It's literally a question, and the only way you get the answer is you read the Bible.
Yeah.
And so mission, nonprofit mission accomplished. Yeah. It's just a wonderful way to help people, I think, see the Bible as just like, you need to reread this. For whatever you think that was in that story, if you actually read the words again, the Bible becomes not boring.
Right.
And I mean, there. So I have like two kind of core verses hang.
Here's some trivia.
Hang the.
we'll test our knowledge.
Yeah, exactly. Let's test your knowledge. But in which book in the Bible mentions a huge man with 6 fingers on each hand and 6 toes on each foot? This is like in the Princess Bride. I think the guy is looking for this guy. Second Samuel 21:20. In still another battle which took place at Gath, there was a huge man with 6 fingers on each hand and 6 toes on each foot, 24 in all. He was also a descendant from Rapha. And so instantly you think, wait, what? Like, okay, now I should look up Second Samuel, see what is going, what kind of battle are we talking about? Why is this giant in there?
Absolutely.
And so there's just little things like that I think, obviously for me, this works for me. This is something I wanted, and hopefully I'm not the most unique person on earth and this works for other people, but just that little nugget, it gets me sucked in to read the story and figure out why is this in the Bible?
Right.
There's all sorts of little details that you just wonder who put that in there. And then now you've just dug a hole and you're going to the next step. So, okay, who wrote the Bible? Who wrote that weird thing in there? That little, and then you've got, 40 authors or however many you want to say. Well, pick however many years. We've got hundreds of years collecting these stories. And you just think, what in the world am I reading? and this is the kind of stuff that's just life-changing, right? Like, this is not going to save us, that we know that there's this six-fingered, six-toed man in the Bible. That's interesting. But to get people down that rabbit hole, just now you're in the Word.
Absolutely.
And after you're doing that, I think we can get to the life-changing stuff, because that's where we meet Jesus.
Well, that kind of raises a question. What demographic? Like, is there a target age bracket, or is this kind of across the board, really?
Yeah, that's a great question. So it's currently a website, and we'll build an app, but I have no idea. So it's kind of like, I love playing with Lego. It's like 0 to 99, or I don't. When do you cut people off?
That's true. 0-year-olds are using websites these days. So.
Yeah. So it's tough. It's tough. Oh, I've got coloring pages for them.
Perfect.
So
that's good.
It's tough. I don't know. It's a website right now. So anybody who can, if you're on a phone, if you're on a laptop, it's It's available. It's on the internet. So I don't know.
Preston, what would be some of the, I guess, most frequently asked questions, you know, and just some hurdles maybe that you see in this developmental process?
Yeah. Well, so we start at questions, and then you get to, obviously, they have read the answer, which is achieving the nonprofit's mission to get people to read the Bible, but you get into different, there's different translations. I don't know if we are aware of this. When you read your Bible, it might not say exactly what's in my Bible. And so the fun, I think, again, rabbit hole where the not boring has just, it's like layers of an onion. This just got shed where all of a sudden I thought we were reading the same book. And yes, but it, the way it speaks to us is going to be different, the way people have translated it. Yeah. I mean, I hate to show my knowledge, but like the revelation that the Bible was not originally written in English might be shocking to some people. So, okay, was
Jesus
it?
Jesus wasn't white.
Right, exactly. I mean,
that's shocking.
So, yeah, these European paintings we have of Jesus is like, is that what you think the guy looked like? Right. And man, just when, I think that's when it becomes rich. Yeah. When we tear down the things we thought we knew and we actually look at literally what the Bible says. I'm not trying to make it say or do anything other than what does the Bible, like you read the Bible, here's the passage, and man, we can wrestle and there's all sorts of denominations and divisions in the Christian church. And I think if we just get back to the core of what does the Bible say?
That's great.
Do we believe in the Bible? Yeah, like that is a hurdle unto itself because, man, if you're clicking on enough of these trivia questions, you're going to find out the Bible says some really weird things. And so, yeah, you have to go back to, do we believe that this is, man, the Word of God? And so, yeah, I've got two verses there just kind of for the nonprofit that if we're going to look at this book and say, I believe in this, I believe in Jesus for sure. Like, okay, but there's some weird stuff I'm not sure if I believe in. You got to look at some of these passages. So we've got 2 Timothy 3:16. All scripture is breathed out by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness. So whenever we think 2 Timothy was written, what does all scripture refer to? And it's like, man, well, now I've got to sit down and take a break because my brain is
six fingers. It's beneficial that, somehow.
Yeah, I don't. Right? Yeah, I don't. Yeah, and so your second one there, after you're okay with that, it's all scripture is breathed out by God. You've got Hebrews 4:12, for the word of God is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing to the division of soul and spirit, of joints and marrow, and discerning the thoughts and intentions of the heart. So yeah, you get to pick, that verse is, too weird. This can't speak to me anymore. This is not living. And then you're faced with which pages do I get to rip out? Cause we should start ripping. There's some weird stuff. I don't know what this means. That's too weird, too crazy. I don't get it. So, man, if we're going to leave that in the Bible, you've got these two verses that really are going to make you want to sit down and have a cup of tea while your brain explodes. I think that's the goal. Yeah. But man, just to get people into that first step, I think when they say the Bible is just boring, how do we shake Christians away from that? I think is the tool I hope Bible can be.
Yeah, and it's fantastic. So I remember sitting down with you over lunch, probably beginning 2019, when we started talking about this crazy idea.
Yeah.
And you're just talking about the idea of boring is because a lot of people say, oh, I've heard that. There's a lot of people in church that are like, I've heard those stories before. So they kind of check out and tune out. And I think one of the things that you said back then that really enticed me was when we can give them scriptures that maybe they breeze over or maybe never even heard or read, like the six-finger man, getting them excited about the Bible again is, I mean, we shouldn't have to sugarcoat the Bible. The Bible is awesome. It's, you know, the Word of God. But when we feel like we've been complacent, how do we reignite that passion for it, right?
Yeah.
So kind of what do you see, you know, for anyone watching, like how are they going to utilize this? Where do you see this going? How is it going to be incorporated in their lives and, you know, lives of churches, whatever it looks like?
Yeah. So, I mean, the beauty of this, and like I said, how I learned, just quick tidbits, is like, do you have 30 seconds? Okay, check this out. Click random question and just see if you know. So I think that's what I've found is really fun. It's just introducing it to people. Mm-hmm. And that's literally, thank you for letting me do a podcast. I'm trying to get the word out that this exists. Because if you can take 30 seconds of somebody's time, and obviously this is on the Infinity Plus bestseller list of the week, like the Bible is circulating many copies and most people have access to one. And if you can introduce it in a way that's new to them, as did you know this is in there? And so I just found like it's a fun way to talk about the Bible in a totally unarming sense with all sorts of people, like every kind of person, the Christian who's been a Christian forever, the new Christian, the person who doesn't go to church, the person who hates church. Did you know this is in the Bible? And then this is like a fish hook, like literally they're reading the word of God. So is it ever bad if somebody is reading the Bible? I mean, I've landed on no, and yes, people have taken the Bible out of context and done terrible things, but once you're in God's word, that's literally the core. When I had to wrestle with building this, I was like, man, is this even good that I'm letting people know that all this weird stuff is in there? Well, yeah, this is like I just read, like these are, the verses, this is breathed out by God. It's in there for a reason. And man, what do you do next is a great question. But yeah, I've just found that hopefully it's a tool that's super unarming in a wonderful way where people can casually talk about it and literally then they're reading the Bible. And so I think one thing that I found is like just talking to somebody, when you say, hey, you should come to church or you should come to my youth group or you should come to this Bible study, just the walls. I mean, they come up for all sorts of different reasons, and there's good reasons, bad reasons, but people just feel judged, or I don't want to take the time, or that's going to be too much of a commitment, or whatever. So literally, I see people using this on their phone when they're bored at coffee or whatever. Do you have 30 seconds to look at something really weird in the Bible?
That's great.
That's too long of a title, but if it was Not So Boring Bible, it would be, do you have 30 seconds to look at something weird in the Bible?
Sounds great. So it is a website, notsoboringbible.com.
Yep.
Right. And what are you, I know we've talked about just kind of transition to utilization in church and children's ministry and just getting the name Not So Boring Bible out there for families to use. Like what's your kind of bigger picture of, you know, obviously there's a website, and if you haven't checked it out, it's really exciting. So go check that one out first.
Yeah, shame on me how long we've been going. NotSoBoringBible.com.
I know.
But yeah, I don't know what it's going to become, so I didn't want to put .com on there because maybe we have a t-shirt cannon to shoot this out of space. I don't know what it becomes. I don't want to limit it to the internet, but it's what a wonderful tool that we have the internet that this can be available to all these kinds of people. I'm going for English speaking, I think, is the only demographic that I have. But then, yeah, like you're talking about, which age group and how people can use it. I don't have a specific target, but I'm trying to make a resource that's good for everybody. Mm-hmm. So like even when we were talking about how young you can zero to whatever, we on notsoboringbible.com, there's coloring pages. And again, what I wanted to get away from is what people know. So, I mean, nothing, whatever coloring pages you have down there. If you Google Bible coloring pages, you have loving Jesus and kids, and you have a big quail. Lamb, you know. Lamb is in there, right. Very popular. Yeah, lamb, yeah. Which is great. Like, I'm not saying we need to do anything different. But sometimes that's going to get boring, and that's when, like, how do you shake these people? And it's not doing anything theatric, not doing anything other than getting them to read what's in here. So awesome. When you look at these coloring pages, you can go to notsoboringbible.com/color. They might be weird, but caution, pump the brakes. Yeah. There's Bible verses on there to back up exactly what this looks like. And it can look different to you. But man, this is what is in the Bible. And so literally I think it's a fun exercise in, do you know what's in the Bible? Because this looks really weird, but also this weird thing that looks weird is in the Bible.
Yeah.
So I think the coloring pages are, like, for me, really exciting to see just kind of a totally different take, not in any other, like, direction or some artist. I mean, it looks different, but also you read it and you draw a page and I'll put it up there because it's like, that's so weird. And that's just awesome to see.
It reimagines it. And
totally. And like some of these things have details that are just a little bit vague. What do you do with that? And like, we don't have all the answers, which is wonderful. And it's just one more way God can speak to us. And like, why did it become breathed out like this? Right. I don't know. Right. But that's his ways are greater than our ways. And so it's fun to wrestle with.
A lot of history. A lot of history in there.
Yeah. So, and history, if you don't like history, you can say boring. Well, you should probably take a look at some of this other weird
Not so
stuff.
Boring yeah. after all.
I mean, if there's some weird history, like let's talk about weird history. We have animals speaking directly to a human. I mean, this is like crazy town.
Like Narnia. What is
going on? So if you didn't know that animals speak directly to people, you know, there's a Bible question. We got Genesis 3:1 and Numbers 22:28. It's just like, to me, I don't know why I get excited about that, but that's like great. All sorts of crazy cool. No,
that's cool. And we are going to be utilizing a lot of your resources. So if you're in Crossroads families, we're going to be taking some of this, and it just supplements what we do teach on a normal basis because it's strictly Bible. But it does bring in a level of excitement, especially for, you know, the kids who are getting to third and fourth grade. They've heard kind of the basic Bible stories for, you know, their whole childhood, and they're transitioning almost to middle school. We want to keep them captivated because the Bible's never boring. And I think that's a beautiful picture that we're painting for them.
Yeah. And that's another resource that I'm working on too, just trying to fit like a family package, what works for, you know, we want the whole family to not be bored, not just the coloring kids. And that middle age is really hard, like 9 to 12. You know, they're just kind of like, have heard it, obviously. I've already colored Big Fish Jonah picture. I've colored my rainbow. And how do you keep them excited and engaged? And it's so tough because that's obviously how they grow up. And man, I've built this kind of agent page, so it's not so boring Bible.com. And then there's all sorts of goodies in there. But this age group, I think, is going to be really fun to talk about different themes. So not so much just the questions and the 30-second forget you, but how do you look at a theme like anger? Mm-hmm. And you've got God being angry, you've got Jesus being angry, and I'm a 9 to 12-year-old, I get angry. Yeah. So how do you relate it in that sense, I think, is something that I'm really excited working on. We've talked about that. I'm really excited to work on that and roll that out. And like I said, I don't know when. Working on it. But excited to see how the Lord leads in this.
Fantastic. Well, as we wrap up here, I think this podcast, again, where can they go to find everything?
Yeah, so it's notsoboringbible.com, the internet, anything with a web browser will work.
And also, we have that link on our weekly email that goes out to everyone. It's at the bottom there. You'll see the link. You can go straight there as well, and this podcast will be on there. Yeah. Preston, thanks for tuning in. Brian, anything else?
Yeah, and just be prepared. I'd hop on soon because it's about to blow up. You'll see it everywhere because we'll be utilizing it, and hopefully
I'm scared,
nationwide.
I'm scared and nervous because obviously I built this tool, and like you talk about demographics, and it's like, okay, how many people are on earth? Like 7 billion. Okay, well, how many people are already Christians? And then you've got that. And so just the breakdown, I just really appreciate you guys obviously being my home church and just the support you guys have had. But like having lunch with each of you guys and like just kind of bouncing the idea off, I credit you guys for not saying this is a stupid idea or just running with it. We had lunch
just
and
so
Steve
crazy
said,
it might work.
Literally in like the first 30 seconds, I love it. And I was like, it's going to be a clear sign. So I'm just really excited because I feel like this thing, it's dangerous and exciting. Like just the Bible in itself, there's so much in here, and you think every household's got one. And it's like, what? There's nothing more like life-saving in your house. And also with a cautionary pump your brakes because there's some scary stuff in there. Yeah, but I'm just really excited for the support. And I mean, I see this thing as like a match, and I see a dry forest.
That's super exciting.
Well, gang, that's we hope that you go to Not So Boring Bible. Check it out, .com. And with your kids, man, to have a little fun around the dinner table, right? Yeah. A little trivia and see who knows some of the answers to this stuff. But thanks for tuning in. I hope you'll go check it out. We're super excited to see where it goes, Preston.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah. Thank you all.